So we're standing in front of a new place we just put up that you just saw run through our factory. This is a around 1,100 square foot bungalow, two bedroom, two bathroom, with a nice open space facing the Gatineau River. So we're gonna have a little bit tour of today. So you just saw this building go through our factory. Now we're just finished assembly and finished our rough-in for our mechanical. So today we're going to highlight a lot of different features and explain how we run our electrical plumbing throughout this space. So here's a good example of some of our electrical that comes up out of the slab. So we have all these conduit. It's a core line conduit that we use to run through the slab and either to right to the utility room or to an interior wall where that switch or plug is gonna be controlled. In this case, we have a much wider opening with a numerous amount of conduits because we not only do have a, this is a, an office corner, so we have a larger box with some networking as well that's gonna go in later, but we also have this channel that comes up to a light switch box above here. Now, we can drill anything that's typically around 18 inches up. As soon as we get to a counter height or a switch height, what we do and what we did specifically in this project is when the panel is on a flat side within the facility, we'll actually core out the backside and integrate a spline and put a piece of plywood back in to create our air tightness. But that gives us a chase on the backside all the way up so that we are able to run that electrical from top to bottom. And that's one of the ways we can get away with running wiring and not interrupting our nice finished surface. So this is gonna be our kitchen. As you see here, these boxes are actually set for tile. This is gonna be the backsplash and we have a tile backsplash. So these boxes are actually purposely set outwards in order to receive the tile so that it's flush. You can see the stove plug is already is cored out of the actual panel as well. And coming along to our plumbing, generally within our concrete slab on grade, it's very typical to have all your plumbing installed ahead of time. And that's the same case here. We're just integrating it up to, and close to our wall system. Moving on to something that is also a challenge within a CLT wall system is our actual HRB unit. So if you look at the ceiling, we have a drop ceiling and we're able to run all our HRB through that utility cavity that we create. Not only the utility for the HRB, but also our plumbing vent and any electrical wiring and pot light as you can see across the ceiling. Here we are in the mechanical room. As you can see, we have all these, the electrical conduit coming in underground. We generally, with majority of our builds, will bring in the all our electrical service in underground. We have our water from well, because we are rural, so we bring in well water. And here we can see our HRV system. We have our intake and our output above. Here we're gonna have a Minotaur unit that is a heat pump, HRV, AC, and heating all integrated into one machine. So that is what's distributed throughout the house. Minotaur is a company actually not far from us, it's out, just outside of Gatineau. Their unit is something we use quite a bit in our buildings due to the efficiency that we get. And generally the size of our buildings is one, it's the single and only unit we need for our mechanical. We do actually pre-install our HRV system prior to building our sub cavity or our utility cavity, giving the contractor the freedom to run everything on the ceiling prior to us putting all the framing in his way. So it is something when we're doing these cavities that we're keeping in mind to make sure that each sub trade comes in and has the most, freedom as possible with certain limitations so that we don't have to frame everything around them. But that's the goal, is to give them that opportunity to run anywhere below that cavity and then we'll install our framing after the fact. So here we are in the master bath. As you see here, we have a framed wall system up on top of our CLT. This bathroom is going to be tiled. Generally, you wouldn't put exterior plumbing on our exterior wall due to the risk of freezing. Because of our performance of our wall system, the zero thermal bridging that's created, there's actually no concern to have this plumbing on our exterior wall. So for this specific project, it's a bungalow with a shed roof. We're very limited in terms of the mechanical where we can position it. General will have maybe a open web floor joist in between stories in a different type of building. So we have a bigger advantage to run most of our mechanical. So this building also has, as you notice here, all interior partitions out of standard 2x4 framing. The client was very adamant about sound, so you also see the mineral wool within our cavity to reduce the sound. So most of the time, for simplicity in mechanical in a CLT wall, the exterior wall system is going to remain CLT, yet the interior walls, if they turn into mechanical walls, which in a house of this size, every wall has an enormous amount of mechanical, then it becomes very crucial to have that flexibility within a standard frame system. There are options as well. It gets more challenging to do all your interior partitions out of CLT as well. That takes an additional amount of planning in order to achieve that properly.